I flew to Querétaro Airport, Mexico, from Houston, and the landscape was like nothing I'd ever seen before. Querétaro is about 90 kilometers from San Miguel de Allende, whereas Mexico City is 300 kilometers. So arid, almost treeless, gray and brown. The academy opened in 1959, making it one of the first Spanish language schools in San Miguel. My teacher's name was David Isorbe. There were other classes that were for more advanced students. Here he's getting the little baby Jesus token from a cake that was brought in to celebrate January the 6th, which in Mexico is called the Dia de los Reyes, the day the three magi came to visit the newborn king. There's also a terraced garden where we had language classes, and the building is quite old. Obviously, it predates 1959, as you can see from the stonework. This was my bed. I rented an Airbnb from Olga Rodriguez, who with her husband was a good friend of Toller Cranston, the Canadian skater who won many world medals and a bronze at one of the Olympics. He retired to San Miguel, became an artist and a furniture designer. Her dining room set here, the chairs were made by him. He died in 2015, and she and her husband bought a good number of things, for example, these sculptured heads that are on the patio, the upstairs patio, where I enjoyed many a late evening, just sitting and enjoying the sunshine. This is the little sitting area outside my bedroom where I enjoyed 74 episodes of a series on Netflix called Las Villa Miser, about three Colombian sisters who almost single-handedly overthrew the Spanish occupiers of their country. To get to school in the morning, I had to walk down Aldama Street. And Aldama, according to Architectural Digest, is one of the most beautiful streets in the world. Now, in the mornings when I walked down, there was usually nobody there except workers, mostly stone workers who were sitting on the sidewalk waiting to be picked up. But in the afternoon and the evening, it was very popular with tourists because you can see the pink wedding cake towers of the cathedral called Parroquia de San Miguel. It's really a popular street. There are wedding pictures taken there and lots of people selling tourist items. Sombrero, anyone? The cathedral was built in 1709 originally, but the facade was changed in 1890 by a European architect who wanted to put it in medieval style, inspired by a church he saw in Belgium. Almost every evening, during the Christmas season especially, there was live concerts and the music was really, really good. This is just a sample. All of this under the watchful eye of this man. The South Americans love their liberators. And San Miguel loves giant puppets. I thought this one had an uncanny resemblance to a young Brian Mulroney. And if there wasn't a concert, you could always count on seeing and hearing mariachi performers in the square. I love that they were younger performers and women. And when those church bells rang out, it was quite the cacophony, but it all added to the wonderful festive atmosphere. Mexico is full of beautiful churches and Canadians. This is Phil and Molly Graham, who I knew from St. John's. Many of you may recognize them. They now live in Atotonilco, about 7 miles from San Miguel. And they're setting up a co-op housing project on some property that they bought. This is the lovely hacienda that will become the sort of central building for members of the co-op. And they were kind enough to show me around. Take a look yourself, who knows? Might be a nice place to retire to. Can't say anything bad about the climate, that's for sure. Molly thinks this platform would be ideal for outdoor yoga classes. And they have lots of land for people to build on. I certainly wish them luck and think it's very courageous what they've done. As Molly says, well, what else is there to do but enjoy these last few decades or even more of our lives? Right on. One weekend, I went to visit the Monarch Butterfly Sanctuary in Cerro Chincua, which is about 3-hour drive from San Miguel Allende, about 253 kilometers. I was there in January, the prime month, I guess, for seeing the butterflies would be March in more numerous quantities, but there were still lots of them. It was really magical. These butterflies fly from North America to Mexico to breed, and I guess it's the young who fly back to North America to feed on milkweed. Remarkable. You had to walk. They say it was 3,000 meters from sea level, but I didn't find it that arduous a walk. It took about an hour from where the buses park, and they advise people to be very quiet while they're watching. Oh yes, and you also have the option of going part of the way by horse. Back where the buses park, there are concession stands run by local people who sell souvenirs all to do with monarch butterflies and who cook in small little restaurants. This is Michael and Pauline Kiley from Peterborough, Ontario. They quite enjoyed their time in San Miguel too. In fact, we got together later for dinner. What's not to like? El día que te encontré, me enamoré. Tú sabes que yo nunca lo he negado. Con saña me lograste enloquecer. Y yo caí en tu trampa ilusionado. One of my favorite places in San Miguel was the public library. You enter a sheltered courtyard. And it's a gathering place for lots of people. It has Wi-Fi. There's a lovely cafe where I had breakfast one morning. Can't remember what this was called, but it was eggs in mole sauce. It was delicious. Language classes go on. There's a bookstore that sells used and new books. Toller Cranston's books have their own display here, his art books. Fabulous, fabulous place. Somewhere I spent a lot of my afternoons. But all good things have to come to a pass, and school ended at the last Friday in January. We had an exam. I did well. I was the oldest person in the class with the least good recall. And I studied hard, and I held up our generation quite respectably, I think. But I didn't learn enough to know what the heck was on these menus. I have to go back and sample some of these foods and find out what they are, and maybe somebody watching this will come with me. I had no trouble, though, taking a stab at trying all the ice cream flavors. And the market, oh my goodness, hidden behind a lot of these stalls are little tiny little eateries, you know, five or six stools at a counter. I really wanted to try the food, but I didn't really understand all that was on the menu, but it all looked really good. And there was an active cultural life for the English-speaking, I guess, expats of San Miguel. This play was about an elderly woman who refused to move into a nursing home. Who'd blame her? We had a lecture. Just love the place where it was held. And a Canadian author named Marilyn Simmons has written a book called Woman Watching about an ornithologist in Canada. And she and her husband also live in San Miguel. I spent a very pleasant Saturday visiting artist studios in this part of San Miguel, which is frequented by artists. You can see from the murals and outside buildings, very vibrant, beautiful place. And I topped off my visit to Mexico by going to Guanajuato City. It's a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It's only about an hour's drive from San Miguel. The artist Diego Rivera was born in Guanajuato, but he didn't spend a lot of his life there. The big church that you see below is called the Basilica Colegiata de Nuestra Señora de Guanajuato. It was built between 1671 and 1676. So ends my brief little tour of San Miguel de Allende and a little talk about what I enjoyed most there. And yeah, I'm thinking about going back next January to learn how to read those menus. Hope you enjoyed it.